Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm showing you my guest design team project for Luisa Heinzel, and I used her, basically used her DigiKit bunny hug. And I made another lab book. At the moment I am totally into the lab book theme. Let me show you around. So one of those gorgeous papers, and yeah, it's very sturdy. I used real file folders, but I enforced them with cardstock and two layers of fabric, as you can see, the stripy fabric in and outside. So very sturdy, and it's stuffed full. So I used this very gorgeous kit to mat all these pages, and I printed it on mostly on heavyweight paper, like photo paper, 160 gram. And yeah, I like the collagey and soft look of it. But let's go into it. So here in the front, we see it's like a frame here and a book plate, and in the back, another page of the kit. And I put some eyelets in there, and I also used them like here in the front. I figured it would be nice to have this elastics here, and you can put lots of things in here. I just put some little tags, which are also in the kit. So there are, let me say, 8 double sheets journal pages, and 3 background journal pages, and there are 5 sheets with ephemera, like these little tags, bigger tags, pockets. And this is just a cutout from one of the journal pages, so you can use them very nicely for journal tags, for instance, and not only for Easter or so, but all kinds of themes. So very versatile. And I put, well, this is an altered envelope, some offcuts and writing space here. And I was also lucky to have some leftovers from an old book from Peter Rabbit. And I use those pages too, because it fits to the kit. So, and here you see, which is very lovely, there are several pages where you see pockets, and I figured it would be very nice to print it out doubled and put a real second layer on it with a pocket. So, and this is also one tag of the kit. And I met the inside flaps here with old book pages from Peter Rabbit. And I also used some old vintage cards I had in my digital stuff. Stash is the right word. So here's another of these big postcards, and here I continued the paper, kind of, so that it's like this rabbit here, which is also fun. So the papers themselves let me create some special layouts, and can be very creative with those papers. And I put two writing spots in there. So here's a simple signature, and I printed some paper from the kit out on some normal paper, and then there are coffee dye papers, ledger from my stash, and of course there's an elastic. So here's another example for this pocket on the paper with, here you see on the mat how this continues. And isn't this gorgeous? I love those layouts very much. Here is a big pocket in the side with another vintage postcard, Easter postcard. And here, this is also very nice. I saw on one page there is like an envelope. Let me open this up here. You see the page here. And I made a real kind of envelope of it by printing on another piece of cardstock, and it's also enforced, and so I have this wonderful flap and can tuck like this vintage postcard here behind. And here's also big space for stuff. I just put a real fan art piece in there, this lovely writing, and on the back you can write also something. So, and you can close everything up with this closure. So, and here in the middle of this first part I included a nice little junk journal. Slides in here. And I made a fabric spine and, yeah, hardcover, kind of hardcover. And for this I used pages from Victoria Designs. I got the big Peter Rabbit pack, and so I had to use them because they fit very well to this. So there are pages from this paper pack, and there are coffee dye papers, so just random nice little Easter journal. And when Easter is over and this is full, you can put another journal in there with another theme. So yeah, this is that. And then here there's another matting with one of those pocket pages, or I made it like a pocket, so I put this on there. And this is just cut out from one of the journal pages, so you see you can make very nice journal cards out of this paper too. Yeah, and here are three little tags like photos from super cute rabbits, and another little tag just in here. So a lot of pockets, a lot of storage place for you. So another pocket page here with this continuing image. Another little tag of the kit. And some more ephemera pieces here. So, and here we come to the first envelope piece with foldouts and little pockets like here for this, also from the kit. And you can, when you open it up, you have here a little tuck spot, and here you see this is one of the pockets, by the way, from the kit, and one of the little tags. So in the middle there is a belly band all matted with papers from the kit, and it's also a little tag from the kit. And here you see the bunny hug. So I guess she used this for the title of this stitchy kit. And there are several little tags from, yeah, actually Peter Rabbit. And so here behind there's another vintage postcard, and here we have this little slot with some more little tags, very cute. And this is one of the bigger tags, and here's another tag or journal card. So when you close this like so, I made this little closure here, and in the back there is a big journal card out of some paper from the kit. So let's move on. And here, just on the back side, there is another envelope piece. Oh, I hope I was in frame. And just put this paper clip away. So in the front, there are several pockets. And when you take this out, you can flip this and you have a nice big writing space. So it opens like this, and here in the back you have it's like a big belly band, a lot of room. I just put another vintage Easter card in there. And here I made a little notebook section, and here's a place for writing. Here is place for this big, or for this vintage Easter card. I'll do this later. The angle is not so perfect here. So you can open this totally up, and here is a little notebook section, and here I put some paper clips on there so we can clip little ephemera pieces in there. So this is that. Let me see how. So it closes like so, and this paper clip helps to close it, of course. So now this part is an envelope part. And again, here this little closure flips up. It's just writing space and a little tuck spot with the card and big pocket for another vintage Easter card. And here it's a double pocket with a tag, and this is also from the kit with this mini journal card in there. So we can close it up again. So here I made a acetate pocket situation here with some more little bunny tags. Bunny tags. So this is the next part. Some collaging and another Easter card, and this is a big side pocket with another Easter card. So here's some more, another card, and here I just put something for coloring, for just drawing paper. And this side I used there for book page from Peter Rabbit book, and there are several little tags like so clipped on there. And behind this there's also a big space here, and I just put this and this tucks behind. So you can storage a lot of things in here. And here I put just elastics in there. I didn't want to include more pages because this is very full already. But you can, if you want, put pages in there, or you can take it away. Or I figured, which is also very handy, this is quite full I mean, it's not very necessary to take a closure, but maybe you wish a closure, and therefore, oh, hello, Lily. Therefore, you can take one of these elastics. Sorry. So one of these elastics, and put them over this, like so. And you can just make so, and you have a little closure for transportation. And yeah, it's your choice. Maybe it's handy when you put it in your bag or something. But if you don't want it, you don't have to. You can leave it here, or you put it inside like it was. So yeah, okay, guys. So I hope I was always in frame. I have to look, but as for now, I say thank you very much for watching this video, and I say bye till next time. Tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal.